There are a few highlights that I want to share with you guys in the month of November. I just came back from a surf trip. What up, guys? Welcome back to this channel, and I am back. It's been a while since I've updated a video. I think it's been 3 weeks. But if you were to follow me on Instagram, I kind of mentioned that I won't be uploading new videos for a while. Reason being, because I was actually in the midst of looking for a new editor to edit my YouTube videos. The process took a while. Good news is that I found someone to partner with, so there will be more videos coming up. So yay, that's good. One thing sorted, and there's are quite a lot of happenings in the month of November. I don't know how time just flies so quickly, because maybe I'm just like constantly on the go. But there are a few highlights that I want to share with you guys in the month of November. I don't think I have uploaded a single video in November, did I? Or I did, like the first week. But anyhow, there are a lot of happenings in November, and I'm very excited to just kind of share a little bit. So the first major highlight in November is that Handmade Heroes turned 6. It's been 6 years. It's been 6 years, but yeah, it's been 6 years. I've decided to do a little celebratory photo shoot for our 6 year anniversary, and I've always wanted to do something fun with like confetti, cake, something vibrant. So yeah, we did a shoot at a hotel that I really love. It's called the Chloe Hotel, and I booked out this room that has a vinyl corner, and I really love the furnishings of the room. So we did a shoot there. We got some friends of Handmade Heroes to come on to join us on this shoot. Everything went well. The pictures turned out really well as well. If you guys want to see it, you can just hop onto like our website or like our social media. There was a part of the shoot that really freaked me. I wouldn't say it freaked me out, but I was freaking out because I didn't know how much mess we actually made. Firstly, the confetti was very loud, and when I popped it, I automatically think like, oh shit, you know, like, and we are in the hotel room and you kind of don't want to disrupt like other guests. So I popped it and it was so freaking loud, and my face, like, it's all just written all over my face.
2, 3. Oh my god, the sign!
Sorry, sorry.
Oh my god, it's everywhere.
Do you have to clean it?
It has really nice noise.
It was literally just raining like confettis. So I was also freaking out because, like, in my mind, I'm just thinking like, how are we gonna clean this up? I just realized I am the only person that is like low-key like freaking out, and everybody was just having so much fun. Anyhow, it's all done. We also managed to clean up. We got like a portable like vacuum cleaner to come in, so everything turned out to be okay. Gels really well with the birthday bundles that we came up with, the limited edition box that we designed, our birthday box, which let me just show you quickly. So it's here, ta-da! So this is Handmade Heroes' birthday box. This is the mini size. It comes in a big one as well. So it says, "Hello gorgeous." Yeah, so this is like a tagline that we use a lot. We try to insert like really cute quotes and cute words like you matter, you're beautiful inside out. And I really like this one because I picked it out. It says good vibes, and then you have a lot more at the back. So this is also one of my favorite, warrior at heart. It goes like alongside with our beauty warrior face mask. We're just trying to like recreate something that's super fun and vibrant. So this is it. The boxes looks very festive as well, so we also want to have that like festive vibe since like year end is approaching. And I think this will be a super cute gift to like your friends or like people you care of, with all the words of encouragement. And we came up with a few bundles that you will be able to save 20% on those bundles because it's our birthday special. So please go to check it out because it's limited time only. Not only you'll receive a limited edition box if you were to purchase those bundles, we also came up with a few cute merches. So we have these really cute mesh bags that comes in 4 colors, but I only have 3 with me right now. So I'm just gonna show you how they look like individually. I am loving these so much because I've been traveling with them, and they're perfect for the beach because you see it's like netted and there are like little holes that's like sand proof. You don't have to be worried that sand will get trapped in there. And this is actually my favorite, one of my favorite bags because the color, it's purple, and the zip is like in this really cute neon salmon color. So this and this, they are in small size. We came up with 2 sizes each. So 2 small and 2 versions of color, and then 2 big ones, which is in this really cute, is it like a fuchsia color? There's one in blue as well, but I don't have it now. So what I use it is, I use it to put like my sunscreen, my essentials. You can also use it as a laundry bag to put like intimates or whatever. Do check them out, guys! This is like the Handmade Heroes birthday special. So, just doing a little bit of like promo here, so don't mind me. The second highlight of my November is that I just came back from a surf trip. Well, I kind of sneaked in like a mini surf session during the weekend. I went to Chirating in Pahang, in Kuantan, which was so fun. I really enjoyed myself and I'm so glad I went. I wasn't really feeling like 100% like if I should go, and I was also like a bit worried like if I were to go, like what about like work right in KL? And you know, you have this anxiety where if you were to leave and then things will just start to fall apart. And no, it doesn't happen. So yeah, I'm glad that I went, and I just have some time to myself just for that short 3 days, 4 days. Yeah, and I got some really, really nice waves. It was a nice ride. I made a lot of new friends, so that was fun. But I'm not gonna reveal too much because I'm gonna save that for the next vlog. So if you want to know more about this trip, just stay tuned for the next video. So that's that. I also got a lot tanner. I don't know if you can see. The third highlight of my November, I did quite a lot in November, but mainly was a lot of work. One of the highlights of my weekend was I went for a pottery class. I have been meaning to try pottery because it looks really, I wouldn't say it looks fun because I'm a very like active person, and pottery is more like calm and really zen. You have to sit there for hours and really just focus and be patient. So I wasn't too sure if I'm gonna enjoy it, but it turned out to be really nice. It's like a very nice activity. It's chill.
So we're here at the Throw and Paint workshop for about 3 hours. It's gonna be a 3 hours workshop. And in the studio right now, so cute.
Okay，表示你看到里面一定会因为我们指甲弄到它有点，那个泥油这样子啊，所以你可以折一半，好，然后抓住它，好，对，如果不可以你就扶一下你的手啊，好，压一下，好的，让我试一下啊，还就下去了。
see.
So pottery was something different. I guess it's a change. It's like a breath of fresh air. So I'm meaning to try it. So I did some research and I found this studio. It's called Berry Pottery Studio, if I'm not mistaken. I will definitely share their Instagram page so you guys can go check it out too. I think they have like a range of workshops that you can join. I do remember seeing a sake glass making workshop, but I did not go for that. I actually opted for a throw and paint workshop, which is about a 3 hour, yeah, it's a 3 hour workshop. And what you get to do in that 3 hours is you will get to mold a mug and then a bowl, and then you get to design and paint over it. Although it says 3 hours, but we actually overstayed our welcome. We ended up staying there for like 5 hours because we were just so caught up with painting. We just kind of want everything to be like perfect. So we just keep throwing paint like over and over and over it. I feel that it's just so much paint on our bowl and mug that it's gonna be so heavy. But yeah, I'm excited to see the final result because it's still at the studio. It's waiting to be processed and you have to fire it and things like that. So it takes about another month. Yeah, a little bit of like the process of the workshop. We went there, when we arrived, like people were like really nice. The lady that was in charge in the workshop, she's like very chill and she's very encouraging.
来来，没事，捏捏很好，只是你拇指可以下来一点，下来一点，对，很好。然后跟你一样，我扶着你就好，你自己上。因为你的力很balance一下，所以就，而且这边已经蛮像你腰的那个形状了。嗯嗯，好，很好。你看你手超稳的，所以OK，你就跳，再躺一下。如果看到它中间还是有一点的，看你手，你的力全部很均匀，你都要讲一讲看啊。
You will be given like clays and then she will kind of teach you how to throwing, they call it throwing, right? So it's like molding the clay into the shape that you want, whether it's like you want to make a mug and how you want the mug to be, and then the bowl, and then she will teach you like little techniques, how to like use your hands and your fingers, I don't know. Yeah, you just keep repeating the process. She will show you first, like the first step is she will demonstrate and then you will do it. Okay, so this class was conducted in Mandarin. So she speaks Mandarin and English. You can also like request her to speak English, but she mainly speaks in Mandarin and she's very encouraging. So she'll keep going like, 你做得很好, like, keep going, you're really good. Like, 可以啊,就继续这样子就好了. Like, she's like super encouraging, which is like really nice. I think we spent like the first 1.5 hours just repeating like the steps and molding the mugs and the bowl. The one that took the longest time was actually the drying part. So you will have to use a hair dryer to get the surface to like dry up until it hardens as well, because the clay is wet and it's soft. So until it hardens, then only you start to attach like the handle to the mug. And then after that process, it's the painting, which is the fun part, I'd say. So you can choose like any designs you want to. The painting took about, I don't even know how long we stayed for the painting, but it's long. It started at 11, was it 10 a.m.? 10 a.m. We only ended at 3 p.m. which is so ridiculous, but they're so nice. Like, no one chased us out, they just let us like stay there. So I guess it's a very good space if you kind of just want like your alone time, or if you're on a date. It's a nice activity, I'd say. It's a nice activity for a date or even with your friends. It feels intimate, I don't know why. It's like a little intimate activity that you can actually do with like your friends or family or like someone special. So yes guys, I think you guys should go give it a try. Why not, right? I mean, it's always nice to try something new in life. But I'm really, really excited for the final result to be out because, I mean, obviously I want to see how it looks like. I hope it's not too ugly. And secondly, I can't wait to just eat ramen with the bowl. That's something that I'm looking forward to very much. So November has been a super fulfilling month. A lot has happened. There was a lot going on. There is still a lot going on in the month of December. Yeah, I hope you guys had a good November and also moving into December. I will see you guys in the next video and stay tuned for my charting trip. And thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next week.